Hi. I hope that you were able to listen to at least one of those versions of Over the Rainbow, and that you were really able to listen to the images and the symbols that are woven throughout that song. Was there any one particular lyric or image that stuck out for you? What was it? Really interesting. I also hope that you were able to listen to Kermit the Frog. I think one of the reasons that I love the rainbow connection so much is that Kermit calls us lovers and dreamers. And I think that's what we all are. We're dreamers. That's what artists are. We dream of things that have never been before and we breathe them into existence. How cool is that? That is our inspiration for our two writing assignments this week. One is to look at one of your favorite villains. You know, we talked a little bit about the witch and how crucial she is in the story of The Wizard of Oz. So I want you to think of some of the other villains that you might know from favorite stories or movies or cartoons. I mean, who's Batman without the Joker? Or who is Spider-Man without Doc Ock? Who is Harry Potter if he didn't have to confront Voldemort? Or Luke Skywalker without Darth Vader? They're important characters, but I'm always curious as what makes them evil. So your job is to write a backstory for one of your favorite villains. You know, on Monday, Miss Bridie talked a little bit about her experience in touring with the musical Wicked. And that's what Wicked does. Wicked explores the backstory of the Wicked Witch of the West, Elphaba. And I think you guys are up to that challenge. So that's number one. Number two is we talked a little bit about Oz being this fantastical world, a world that never existed except in Frank Baum's imagination. So I want you to take 5 minutes, set a timer, and without overthinking it, come up with names, fantastical names of places, absolutely brand new places that have never before existed. Just write them down, don't overthink it, and then stop that timer. Look at your list and decide which is the one that is the most intriguing. And once you've picked a name of the place, take another 5 minutes and flesh it out. What do you imagine this place is all about? Think of what do the buildings look like? What are the houses like? Who lives there? What color is the sun? What color are the meadows? What do people eat there? What kind of creatures live there? How do people get around? Let your imagination run wild. Now, those are two big writing assignments, but I do hope that you're continuing to keep a journal for yourself, whether it's that visual journal or a written journal. You know, one of my favorite journals is one that my husband gifted me, and it's actually a Wizard of Oz journal. The front of it says, "True courage is in facing danger when you are afraid." And it's really special because the lines of it are actually the words from the book itself. So it's pretty special. But I do hope that you're continuing to write. Again, if you're stuck for an idea in the link below, it has some different writing journals that might spark your interest, and it also details those two writing assignments that we just talked about. So we will be back on Friday to introduce Dorothy's friends, the Scarecrow, the Tin Man, and the Lion. But before we go, we need to sing our goodbye song. So does everyone have their puppet ready? Here we go. We've played and talked as one, and hope that you've had fun and sung with all your heart. Do, 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 do. We hope that you'll come and play with new things to try each day while we are far apart. I'll see you later, friends.